Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's fill the room with an aroma of praise this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's forget about all of the Hakarubo Shako Rubo Shaki. Yero Shako Rubo Shaka. Yerubo Shaki and a Ramoki Shaka. Uriamo Shaka. Yanomo Shaki. Let's forget about all our worries and our troubles in this evening. Hallelujah. But we shouldn't be worrying anyway with a God like this that we serve. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father. We are thankful, Father, for another opportunity to be in your presence, Father. Father, we understand, Father, that trouble will come from the left and to the right, Father, but we shall stand in the direct path of you, Father, for we know in your secret places, Father, we shall be kept. No matter what's going on, Father, in our lives, Father, we understand that you are the head of our lives, so it's got to work out for our good, Father. As long as we're standing in your will, Father, we know that no matter what happens, Father, it is working out for our good, for your word says, all things work for the good of those who love you and are called according to your purpose, Father. And we are called according to your purpose, for we are looking for your will for our lives, Father. We look for nothing else but for the will of your word, Father. We look for nothing else, Father, but for the will of our life that lines up with the will that you set upon this earth, Father. We are looking to be recreated to what you had for us in the beginning, Father. For what you had for us in the garden, Father. Father, we look for nothing but to be kingdom citizens on this earth, Father. We do not look to be a part of this world, Father, but we look to be kingdom citizens and an example, Father, in this world today, Father. We look, Father, to the hills which cometh our help, Father. When things don't look right around us, Father, we know that we got a helper, Father. We know that we have a creator, Father. We know that we have a supreme Father who can look over us, Father, who can guide us through our darkness, Father, who can guide us in this dark world, Father. We look to you. We look to you. Father, we send out a special prayer right now, Father, to those who are dealing with sickness on today, Father. Not just sickness of the body, Father, but also sickness of the mind, Father. Who are not well in the body and who are not well in the mind, Father. For we know, Father, all things start with the correct mind, Father. I heard the word restoration, and that is what we need in this time, Father. We are looking for restoration to start in our mind, that it may trickle down to our body, that we may be who you have created us to be in this time, Father. Oh, Father, we are losing our people, Father. The enemy is ramping up like never before, Father. We see trouble coming from a mile away. So we're asking right now, Father, for a restoration favor, Father. We know that you are able, Father. Not in anything that we can do, Father, but through your goodness, through your grace, through your mercy, through your favor, Father, that these things can happen, Father. Through your Son, who you sent to die, to re-correct us, Father, to restore us, Father, to see a reconciliation upon this earth, Father. We are looking to you, Father. For we know in our own flesh we are not able, but through your Spirit, Father, come in power. I feel the power come, Father. So we ask these things and all things through your Son's mighty, mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give him a hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to welcome every Hallelujah. 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 Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Y'all know if we go off of how things look, if we go off of how things feel, the enemy is able to trap us every time.
Yes.
If we're moving off of the things that we see, then the word says that we're not moving by the Spirit. If we're only moving in the direction of how we feel, then the word says that we're not moving in the Spirit. I understand the battles that we're fighting because the flesh is warring against the Spirit. But the Spirit is also warring against the flesh. Y'all ain't listening to me. So we've got to stand on the side of the Spirit and fight with the Spirit against the flesh in order for us to walk in the Spirit. Hallelujah. 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 Again, I'd like to welcome everybody out to the wave, where we give our attempt for change. Where we look for nothing but to change. Where we look for nothing but to change. To change all of our fleshly ways. And accept our spiritual inheritance. For that is our portion. Hallelujah. But again, we want to welcome everybody to the wave, and we're not going to hold it up for too much longer. We're going to do sort of a panel thing today, but me and Bishop kind of split some time, so we're going to go ahead and get started. At this time, we're going to call up Bishop. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Oh, bless the Lord.
Oh, my soul. Oh, my soul. Hallelujah.
And all that is within me.
Yes, it's a
bless this holy name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We want to say good morning to everyone. And we certainly thank God for being in this place today.
Hallelujah.
And for we feel something, amen, in here today. Come on. I don't know how loud I need to talk. And I don't know how fast I need to say it. But I'm going to say it like I see it.
Come on.
Come on.
Yes.
That's the way you got to say it.
Hallelujah. Amen.
I thank God for just being here.
Yes.
And being able to look upon faces of my fellow man.
Yes.
Thank God for my brother. I haven't seen him for a while, but I thank God for him to be able to see him today.
Hallelujah.
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 I want you all to know one thing. This is probably going to be basic. A review.
Come on.
All right.
Come on. We like basic reviews. That's what we need.
Sometimes we got to go back. Hallelujah.
Yeah. I feel something.
Come on.
Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, all of your benefits.
Hallelujah.
For your loving kindness
and for your patience.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And we pray, oh God, that you would just speak to our hearts. Stir up out your minds. Show us ourselves. In Jesus' precious name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, God. I'm going to look at 1 Timothy, the 6th chapter, and the 11th verse for just a minute. 1 Timothy 6 and 11. I think it's a very familiar passage.
All right.
Praise the Lord. This is the King James Version, so it shouldn't be that hard to find. And if you ain't there, you'll catch up. But thou, O man of God, flee these things. Good. And follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold
the good fight
on eternal life.
Mm-hmm.
Whereunto thou art also called and has professed a good profession before many witnesses. I give thee charge in the sight of God, who quickened all things, and before Christ Jesus, who before Pontius Pilate witnessed a good confession. Amen. I got that scripture because of what we are so familiar with. We are so familiar with the kingdom of God. You know, seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
And so, this scripture is in line with seeking.
Come on.
And one of the things that we need to do before we get so far into the kingdom, we need to pursue but we need to seek after what Timothy is talking about here. The righteousness and godliness and faith, the love, patience, and meekness. Pursuit is one of the things of how we seek. The Hebrew term is rada.
Come on.
Just the original term for pursuit, rada. And it's spelled R-A-D-A-P-H. You can pronounce it like you want to pronounce it.
Right.
It means to seek and chase something with great effort and energy. The idea is not just pursuit, but to relentless chase and take hold of righteousness and love. These are non-negotiable core virtue of the kingdom of God.
In seeking, there are several other passages that we need to understand. We need to study. We need to explore. We need to understand. And understanding was got my attention. Because the meaning of understanding is skill, a capacity for discerning a right course of action and then having the self-discipline to follow through on the action.
That's good.
The other pursuits and seeking is learn, consider, desire. They have passion, diligent. All of this is equated to the fact of getting into the kingdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
Now we know, understand that we have been called so-called Christian for a long time.
Uh-huh.
And we use that term of being saved.
Uh-huh.
Teach us.
And I'm reminded of the disciples walking with Jesus. And they asked him a question in the first chapter of Acts and said, Lord, will thou restore again the kingdom unto Israel?
Uh-huh.
And Jesus responded to them and he said, it's not for you to know the time, the season that's in the Father's power. But then he gave them a commission. He told them to go and preach the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
And he told them where to go.
Mm-hmm.
So later on, the multitude heard him. In the second chapter, whenever he reminded them, he said, let all the house of Israel know for surely that this same Jesus, whom y'all have crucified and hanged on the tree, that God has made him both Lord and Christ. And it kind of pricked them in their hearts. And they said to the disciples, men and brethren, what must we do?
Mm-hmm.
And they said, repent, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So now there's many of us have received the gift of the Holy Ghost, but we have let down the principles of the kingdom. I hear somebody was saying, you can be saved and go to heaven and still miss out on a lot of stuff.
Come on.
But I'm going to say to you, many of us have been saved, as we say. Many of us have received the Holy Ghost, and many of us have spoken tongues.
Mm-hmm.
But somewhere down the line, things didn't go quite well, and I think some of what we have received was like what happened with the sower. Some of it
feeling stony places.
Uh-huh.
And in a while, when the sun came out and began to burn, it kind of vanished away. We didn't carry it out in the way that God had intended for it to be. And we went our way. I hope y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm just trying to refer to something.
Come on.
I have something like called a subject. And I'll give it to you in a minute. Praise the Lord. I told you this is like a review I want to talk to you. Hallelujah. But I just don't see us benefiting from what Jesus came and set the example for us to do. Because it seems as though that we are so vexed, whether it be physical or spiritual. We are in a different place from where he would have us to be.
Yes.
Now, if I were use a subject or a topic today, it would be undeserving favor don't please the king. Come on. Okay? Undeserving favor don't please the king. You know yourself that the word teaches us that it's impossible to please him without faith.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I don't want y'all to think I'm making up some stuff. Undeserving favor don't please the king. To benefit, we must honor the king. To benefit from what the king has given us, we must honor him. And we have failed to do this. Praise the Lord. So, therefore, I would like to look at Matthew chapter 4 for a minute. If you would. Matthew chapter 4. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Father, we thank you.
And I'm going to read, verse 23. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom. And healing all manner of sickness and all manner of disease among the people. And his fame went throughout all Syria. And they brought unto him all sick people that were taken with divers diseases and torment, and those which were possessed with devils. And those that were lunatics and those that had the palsy, and he healed them. That lunatic caught my attention.
All right.
That lunatic can be kind of expressed in many different ways. And one of the ways that caught my attention is with the lunatic. You can be possessed, but they also express lunatic.
Come on.
To say people are crazy. Crazy people. Just being crazy. Just acting the fool.
Come on.
Yeah. But my main objective is that what what Jesus is saying here in 23. And Jesus went about all Galilee teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom. So when he did this thing, you see what he started doing. He started healing people. But see, here's the thing about it is, Jesus, when Jesus came, I don't know how we look at this. When Jesus came, Jesus didn't come as Gabriel.
Come on.
He didn't come as no angel.
Right.
The Bible says he was in like passion as a man, although he was 100% spiritual and 100% man.
Mm-hmm.
But what he's doing is in like passion of a man.
Come on.
You know, in the book of James, James expressed something about Eli being like passion, who prayed and asked the Lord not to let it rain for 3 years and 6 months, and it rained not. Mm-hmm. And he prayed again, and it rained. Now, I hear what I'm trying to get to, y'all. Listen to me. Hallelujah. This thing is getting more closer to me than it's ever been in my life, because we failed to carry out the mission that Jesus has come to set up for us.
Come on.
Hallelujah. You see, here Jesus came, and when he started his mission, he started healing all manner of sickness. And praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Why in the name of God would he want us to be sick?
Mm-hmm.
Why would he want us to be vexed? Oh, praise the name of our God. Somehow we got this thing twisted up.
Yes.
And when he anointed his disciples and sent them out, and he told them to go and do the same thing that he's doing here, amen, in 23.
Mm-hmm.
He told them to go and heal the sick, raise the dead, and give sight to the blind. Y'all ain't hearing me.
Come on.
Oh, praise the name of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Somewhere down the line, out of all the years that I've been patting my hand, amen, and stomping my feet and speaking in tongues, I've been missing something.
Come on.
Lord have mercy. Oh, praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. Evidently something wasn't lined up right. Hallelujah. And I'm determined that it would be lined up. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Before he opened up the disciples' understanding, you know, amen, that their employment, amen, was fishing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Amen. And they was out, amen, on their business and doing their job.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Jesus. And amen, for some reason, amen, it seemed as though that everything shut down, and they wasn't, amen, getting anything done.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And they was out on the job, and amen, and they didn't catch any fish,
mm-hmm,
amen, all night.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So here they are, amen, up here, mending the nets, and amen, shutting down and forming up, amen, the nets and closing up, amen, the marketplace.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Because, amen, they've been toiling all the night long,
mm-hmm,
amen, and they haven't caught anything.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And moments later, amen, here comes a man, amen, walking by.
Mm-hmm.
And he stopped in, and amen, and he asked him a question. He said, amen, have you any meat? And they said, we've been toiling all the night long, and we hadn't caught a thing. And we're getting ready to put a sign on the door.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, closed.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, because we hadn't caught nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And this little man told him, said, look at him, said, Lord, out. For another drop.
Mm-hmm.
And an argument started. Amen. Peter began to argue with the man and said, amen, that's very unusual.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You don't cast a net in the daytime.
Mm-hmm.
Because the fish, amen, can see what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, let me say it. Amen. God have put something in a fish.
Come on.
Uh-huh.
If any of you, amen, ever been fishing, you know you got to put a bait on a hook.
Uh-huh.
Because if you put the hook in there without the bait on, the fish will see, amen, that there's a trap set up for them.
Uh-huh.
Y'all ain't hearing.
Uh-huh.
Amen. That's why when you see someone go fishing, amen, with the rod and reel, amen. They got a phony little thing on it, and
mm-hmm.
and when they throw it in the water, and they begin to bring it in, hit it with it,
mm-hmm.
and make the fish think something on it alive,
mm-hmm.
and they will attack it.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah!
Wow.
So what I'm saying to you is that, amen. The argument was because you don't cast your net in the daytime.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Because the fish don't get in the net in the daytime.
Right.
But Peter said, but nevertheless, at your word. Amen. We're going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And what they didn't understand was that Adam came by. That's what they didn't understand. But you, the reason why I say Adam came by, remember in Genesis 1 and 26, amen, the Lord had given Adam his assignment, and he told him he wanted to rule everything on the earth. Amen. The fishes of the sea and the birds of the air. Are you getting me? Hallelujah. Everything is under his subjection.
Come on.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So Adam told Peter, said, amen. I'm talking about the second Adam. Come on.
All right.
Come on.
Come on.
Hallelujah. He told him to cast his net out there. When he cast his net out there, amen. Adam told the fish to get in there.
Uh-huh.
He had authority over it. He told the fish to get in there. And the fish started crowding in there.
Uh-huh.
I mean, they got in there more than what they should have been getting in there.
Yeah.
And they said, the boss done spoke, we get in here.
Uh-huh.
And then they tearing up the man's net.
Uh-huh.
And they put so many in there, they couldn't draw it up. So they had to call a man for help.
Uh-huh.
Let him
listen.
But somehow we got on the wrong track.
Yes, right. Yes.
Because he told them in the first chapter of Acts, amen, he said, hallelujah, amen, after the Holy Ghost come upon you, you shall have power. And this is the same power that rose Lazarus from the dead. The same power.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because we are made in the same image.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. I'm about to finish.
Yes,
I just want to repeat this a little bit more. Praise the name of God. I just want to say hallelujah. Listen to me. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. If I'd have been seeking this thing right, amen, I wouldn't have all of this neuritis. Amen.
Ah.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
And these artificial hips.
Come on.
He has given us authority. Amen. Over diabetes and
come on.
Amen.
That's
hallelujah.
Right.
And all of this stuff. Listen to what I'm saying. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. And you know, there was a time, and I'm going to get out of your way. There was a time when this man was sick, and he asked the Lord to heal him. Amen. And the Lord said, be it unto you. Amen. Your sin is forgiven. Amen. What am I saying? Oh, praise the Lord. I'm saying, amen, sickness, amen, is sin. Yes. Amen. Yes. Y'all ain't getting it. Huh? Amen. Hallelujah. Sickness, amen, was not something, amen, that the Lord gave us. Oh, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But I want you to understand and to know, amen, that we need to get a different mindset.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. We need to pursue these things. Amen. Praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. Amen. We need to study. Amen. We need to explore and understand. We need to learn and consider. We need to desire the passion. Amen. And do it diligently.
Yes.
Amen. That we might, amen, get in the place where God wants us. I hope, amen, somebody's hearing me today. Amen. Praise the name of our God. Amen. I hope my twin daughter, amen, is on this channel. Do y'all hear what I'm saying to you today? Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the name of our God. Amen. Because, hallelujah, amen, I'm trying, amen, to line things up right. Amen. In my life. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Because I know, amen, hallelujah, if Jesus is saying what he's saying to us, amen, he means exactly what he said, because he's not a God that can lie.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
And may heaven smile upon you.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to get out of the way so fast can come on and do what he's going to do.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I feel pretty good.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Good.
Yeah, I give Bishop Lee a clap for prayer.
Amen.
Good. Oh, good. I mean,
not
that's the benediction.
Thank you, God. When this was given to me to do this work, y'all literally said to me, he said, y'all ain't gonna tell each other what y'all gonna speak about. Normally when you do a panel, you tell folks, you give them a topic. Why you gotta do that? Why should you have to do that? Why shouldn't you just believe in what? Why shouldn't you just believe that if he's going to give you a word, that the word should align?
Yes.
That's evidence.
Yes.
If I got to tell you what the Spirit is saying, that ain't the Spirit talking.
That's right. Come on, come on, come on.
If I can bind you to a box of what you're supposed to talk about, what if the Spirit want to talk about something else?
That's right.
So you done confined me to a box. But what you did was you put the Holy Spirit.
Go ahead.
And he said to me, you're going to finish off what he going to talk about. But he didn't tell me what he was going to talk about. But I got confidence. See, I have a life worth of evidence of what he can do. So I don't have to question what he say to me. Y'all ain't listening.
Amen.
The reason why we question him is because we don't have evidence of him in our life. You left some of that still up in me. You left some of it up in me. We don't have evidence of him in our life. This is why we still question.
Yes, yes.
Then we call it, we going into sick rooms, and we going into places where, and we just think we can just take on healing power.
Mm.
But we ain't got no evidence of.
Come on.
We got a thing about us where we want to skip steps, y'all.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wow. And there's a reason why. We're going to talk about what that reason was. Why Bishop was talking, the Holy Spirit laid something on my heart, the way he said, do y'all know the flesh is inherently lazy? Do you know that? The flesh is inherently lazy. Because the flesh only has one job, to react. The flesh is not supposed to lead. Y'all ain't listening to me, man. The flesh was never created to lead. In fact, when the flesh was formed, it was nothing. It was like the world before God started setting stuff in place. It was void. Y'all ain't listening to me, man. When he finished the flesh, the Bible don't say that the flesh did nothing.
Right. Right.
It don't say that the flesh moved its arms. It don't say the flesh blinked its eyes. It don't say the flesh did nothing, because the flesh can't do nothing but react. It wasn't till after he breathed his spirit in him that the flesh reacted. This is why the flesh is inherently lazy. Because before the spirit came upon the flesh didn't do nothing. Y'all ain't listening to me.
Go ahead.
Y'all know that people say that working out takes mental capacity. Mm-hmm. That's why they say people can't work out. It's because you got to be mentally. What they're saying is the spirit has to overcome the flesh.
Wow. Yes.
Let me get that little piece of paper out of the way so I can get out y'all work.
Come on.
The flesh can't do nothing but react. But in the garden, when they sinned, they gave the flesh power. They gave the flesh a voice. They opened up the eyes of the flesh. Some of us call it our third eye. Yeah, you got to open your third. You better leave stuff alone.
That's right.
You better leave stuff alone. If it's a rock, let it stay on the ground. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah, they got these stones and these stuff. You better leave it on the ground. Messing with stuff.
Go ahead.
Anyway, I'm going to go ahead so I can get on out y'all way. Man, Bishop brought it, man. Bishop brought it. And I'm going to expound upon what he was talking about, because that's how the spirit works. He set the premise, and I'm about to try to bring it home. I don't know that I can follow that, but I'm going to try. Because what he was talking about was this power that we gained when we took on this new birth. Y'all hear what I said? He was talking about the power that was given to us when we took on this new birth, this thing we call being saved or being born again. So we going to expound upon that. Ha! Alright, so I call this check engine light. How many of us got a check engine light on? I'm talking about in your life. I ain't talking about in your car.
Right.
In your life.
Yes.
Everybody should have raised their hand. Because there's constantly a check engine light on in our life. There's something that needs checking. Brought to you by your way is not working. That's why the check engine light is still on.
That's good.
It ain't even a new check engine light.
Yes.
You ain't fixed the last problem. Because your way is not working.
Amen.
Ain't that cute? Oh, hold on. Y'all can hear it. Can everybody see it? Reacted the same way I thought you would. All of it was funny until you got to the last one, wasn't it? All of it was cute until it wasn't cute no more, wasn't it? But what did all of them have in common?
Following.
And they was all babies, right?
Yeah.
Behaviors. Behaviors. The way in which a human or animal act or conducts themselves, especially towards others. We are all born with natural behavior. And during the course of our life, we learn needs. Y'all with me? A child learns behaviors through its environment and the people whom they see growing up. Most of our ways of thinking are shaped as a child, and throughout the course of our development, things are added to them or taken away from them. Y'all with me? So what we just saw was a video of children mimicking the behaviors of others. Y'all got me? Some of them children will never change those behaviors. Y'all ever seen a young person walk like an old person? I'm talking about a baby. I'm talking about, boy, you walk like you old. Or there's a person that walks kind of slow and mimics the behaviors of somebody else in your family. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? It's because they learned those behaviors growing up. And those behaviors are hard to change. Do you know why? Because the flesh only knows how to react. And whatever you teach the flesh to do, that's what the flesh will do. Y'all with me? So y'all know how it was funny all the way we got to the last one? Where the little boy had his hand cocked like this number right here? He was born that way. Now he wasn't. He learned that way. He learned that way. That thing funny till it ain't funny no more. But somebody was laughing. Because it's cute right now. But if he gonna learn to walk like mama like that, he gonna learn how to carry a pocketbook like mama like that. He gonna learn to grab mama lipstick like that. He gonna learn how to put on mama heels. Do y'all understand where I'm going? These things grow. And the more you teach your flesh, the more the flesh reacts to. There's a saying that there is no manual to being a parent. Y'all ever heard that before? There ain't no manual for this. Y'all ever heard that? If we believe this, we are truly mistaking ourselves. If there ain't no manual to how to raise a child, then what is the Bible?
Right.
No, you don't want to read the manual of how to raise a child. John 3 and 6 through 7 says, that which is born of the flesh is flesh. Simple. Just like the video we just watched. If you only teach flesh, all you ever gonna know is flesh. A few years back, those BBL things became popular, right? Everybody flew to Mexico to get one. Right? They saw something fleshly and they wanted it. They were taught flesh, so they went and got fleshly things. Simple concept. Right? And that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. So we got to stop saying there ain't no manual to raising children. The reason why we feel like there ain't no manual to raise children is because we know that if we say there's a manual to raise children by, then we know if we're children, we got to be raised by the same manual. Y'all listen, I'm going to talk to you good. Marvel not, I say unto thee, ye must be born again. This is that power Bishop was talking about. That same thing, that being born again. Right? So we know that if we have to be reborn, we become what? Right, but what do we become again? Children. If you get born again, you become a baby again. So, born again. Many don't understand. I don't have a lot, y'all. I'm going to try to hear you. I know. Many don't understand this concept because they look at the outward appearance and say, but I'm an adult. I haven't been through too much of my life to be you say that I'm a child again. So you look at your flesh, and your flesh appears to be grown.
But the scripture says, those who give into the flesh are what? And those who give into the spirit are what? So if you only are concerned with how your flesh looks, then you only react to the flesh. But you are an adult in the flesh. Being born again is a spiritual process. When you become born again, don't nothing on your outside change. Nothing. You can't even tell something happened. Unless the spirit was just high in the room and you blah, 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 that. But for most part, don't nothing change. At least you don't think it does. Although your outward appearance appears as an adult, you are a baby in the spiritual realm who must be trained and raised all over again. So, if we already know that there is a manual to raising a child, then there's a manual to raise us. Y'all ain't listening. I'm going to get there quick. Because we see now that we are spiritual babies needing to be trained all over again. Knowing that we may see our flesh, but the flesh is not what we go off of.
Y'all listen to what I'm telling you.
This is why we walk not by sight. Does that make sense? Because if you look at your outward appearance, you're going to behave as your outward appearance. But if you look inside, you will behave like a spiritual being, knowing that you need a father to train you. If you look in the mirror,
oh, I'm about to go do what I want to do.
But you, if you look inside, Father, what can I do today?
Right.
Y'all ain't listening.
Right.
This was the problem Nicodemus had of understanding the new birth. Y'all know the story? Y'all remember the story of Nicodemus? Nicodemus went to him at night and said, he was asking him how to obtain the kingdom of heaven, right? And he told him, you must be born again. Nicodemus answered in the flesh. He answered with a fleshly mind. So you telling me I got to go back into my mother's womb? That's a fleshly answer. But that's what we say. Well, you know, we're not supposed to do that. Well, he know my heart. That's a fleshly answer. I don't think you're supposed to be. I'm grown. That's a fleshly answer.
Right.
We're gonna get
right,
that.
Right.
So now understanding that we are now newborns. Would you allow your newborn to go out and just do whatever they want to do? Hey, if your baby wanted to go out and just do whatever they wanted to do, would you allow them? Or would you put some restrictions on that? They require supervision. So if you, being an earthly father, know what to do to your children.
I'm going to use it with the gifts, but I'm going to use it like this.
If you know, as an earthly parent, what to do to your children, how much more do your heavenly father know what to do with you? The same process it took to raise you as a fleshly child is the same process Yah takes you through to raise you as a spiritual child. Things must be relearned. Y'all with me? Do y'all understand now that you're babies with your grown self? Y'all understand where I'm at? You have to learn to forgive yourself. You are no longer the same person. Swallow that for a second. Go ahead and forgive yourself. You can do that right now in your seat. You ain't got to wait. There ain't something you got to wait for. You can do it right now. Just go ahead and forgive yourself. Yep, you messed up. Now forgive yourself. You can't move on until you forgive yourself. You can't even forgive somebody else until you forgive yourself. That's why the Bible says treat others the way you want to be treated. But if you don't see yourself as something, So you first got to learn to forgive yourself before you can forgive anybody else. Mm-hmm. But it's hard to forgive yourself if you can't understand accountability. If you can't see your wrong in situations, you can't forgive yourself. That's why it's so hard for you to forgive yourself. I ain't do nothing. You did something. Mm-hmm. I don't care if it was a minute thing. You did something. You have been made new. New. Not old. You have been made new. You can't allow the enemy to present your old ways to you in your new life. You can't allow the enemy to present your old ways to you in your new life. And the only way to do that is to forgive yourself. Because the process of forgiving yourself is admitting your wrongdoing. The enemy can only use against you what you're not willing to confess. Mm-hmm. Forgiving yourself is a process of confession. Mm-hmm. Whatever you keep secret, the enemy's going to bang you upside the head with. Mm-hmm. Because you're trying to keep a secret. He gonna keep reminding. Oh, they talking about you. Let's say you stole a stapler from work. I know y'all don't steal. Let's say you stole a stapler from work. You gonna feel like everybody at work talking about you stealing that stapler. Ain't nobody see you do it. Because the enemy got something over your head. So now he's gonna utilize that to make you feel like everybody talking about you. It don't have to be a stapler. Whatever it is going on in your life, that secret that you holding, that's why you feel like everybody talking about it. So you react to them thinking. No, you're reacting to you thinking they know what you're talking about. Most of the arguments you get in is because you holding the secret and you feel like somebody's talking about that secret. Y'all ain't listening, but I'm going to talk to you. You're reacting on how you feel like they talking. They ain't even said. But that's how you feel. Because you got a secret. Forgiving yourself is the process of confession. How can you confess something that you can't take accountability for? You can't allow the enemy to present your old ways to you in your new life to trick you to go back to your old ways. Because that's what he does. He piles up old ways enough to make you feel like you're not worthy to walk in your newness. And he tricks you to going backwards. Every time you do something wrong, the first thing you want to do is hide. You want to hide. You don't want to be around people. You want to get by yourself. The enemy is tricky and crafty in doing that. Let me get by myself. I don't need to go to church. I don't need to go to an assembly. I don't need to go around people. I just need to be by myself. It's ironic that in the times we need him most are the times we run from him. Mm-hmm. Huh? Yeah, but I didn't. But that's when you need him. If your child gets in trouble, do you want them to continue in the trouble or to come? Because this is what happens. When you get in trouble, you try to fix the trouble, which gets you in more trouble.
Yes.
If your child was in trouble, do you want them to continue in the trouble or to come to you and tell you what's going on so we can fix this trouble that you in? Y'all ain't listening to what I'm telling you. I'm trying to help you.
Right.
Because you don't know how to, flesh don't know how to fix spiritual things.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. So how are you going to fix it? How you gonna fix it? You gotta go to the Father. You gotta go to your parent and say, look, I messed up. And I don't want to keep this thing going. This is why they say a lie only compounds more lies, because you gotta keep lying to cover up that one lie. But if you go to the Father and say, look, I messed up. I want to fix this thing. I don't want to keep stacking up debt. Second Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore any man be in Christ, He is a new creature. So when we became saved, born again, we became new. New. But I remember we used to new. Let that be your word for people, man. And you remember back in the day, new. You ain't got to say nothing else. Just new. I remember when you used to new. It's the old me. I'm new. What's your name? New. Women, y'all can say new, new. Old things are passed away. I'm not even him no more. But that's one of our biggest problems. We became new and still trying to prove to the world we still down. We act totally different around believers than we act around our family. We had a whole teaching about being one person. And until you understand this concept of being one person, you're going to struggle. You're going to struggle. You got to be this way for this person. You got to be this person around this person. You got to be this way for this person. And you're trying to find out why you got all these schizophrenic ways. You don't even know who you are. You're supposed to be new. Just practice being a new baby. People can't make you feel bad about what you don't know. Man, I wish a teacher would send my son home and call him stupid. I'd go up there to that school and call her stupid. I meant what I said. You mean to tell me, I got in trouble for this in the third grade. You mean to tell me I sent my son to school where you get paid to teach him? And you had the audacity to call him stupid? He came to school because he didn't know. Bring home all that homework. I just left work. I don't want to come home and do homework after I left work. I didn't go to school for 8 hours. Teacher, why you at school? Bringing them home and making me do extra work. Get your parent to help. No, you ain't. Send me some of that money to the house. I'm sorry, this is a sidebar. People can't make you feel bad about what you don't know. God don't even hold you accountable for what you don't know. Because he know you a baby. He know he gotta raise you, but once you know now, don't act like you don't. Huh? Once you know, don't act like you don't. But you have protection with the Father. But when you walk outside and you put on your flesh, you in the door again. So you, y'all ain't listening to me. I'm trying to help you. That ain't got nothing to do. I'm not held accountable for you for what you do when you grown. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, look. Pay attention. All things are become new. Not just you. All things. So your old stuff got to go. Listen. Your old stuff is what got you in trouble in the first place. I'm trying to give you new stuff that keep you out of the old way. But we become babies. We get in him. We get these new things and try to take these new things to the world to shine. It don't work that way. Because every time you leave the house and you put on your flesh with your grown self, that ain't got nothing to do with him. His house, his rules. You go outside. Yeah, you can do what you want to out there, but I'm not held accountable for what you do out there. But as long as you in the spirit, 5-18 says, and all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Christ, and hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation. There's a ministry of reconciliation. So why don't we know what that reconciliation means? It sounds important. How are we living in this life? How are we walking this walk and don't know that concept? But we slanging oil everywhere and you're shouting at the altar. You're just throwing oil everywhere. But you don't even know what being reconciled means. We're babies. We're children. That's what it means to send homework home. You didn't do your job at the schoolhouse, so you sent them home hoping that I can finish off what you didn't do. The father don't never do that. God, listen to what I'm telling you. I'm almost done. The great exchange, that's what I like to call it. Reconciliation is kataliage. It means to exchange. That's what he mean by old things pass away, behold, all things become new. It's an exchange. I'm exchanging your old stuff for your new stuff. Come on, y'all. You can give up your old stuff because I'm going to give you new stuff. And this stuff won't make you have to put on your old flesh. It means to exchange. Figuratively to adjust. I like the word adjust because y'all don't like the word change. That is to restore. That's what Bishop was talking about earlier. Mm-hmm. To the divine favor. Mm-hmm. He's trying to get us back to that power. That same power that he was talking about that Adam had, that Christ walked around with, which was exactly Adam, you have in you now. When you take on Christ, he gives you back that divine power. We supposed to command the fish to jump in the bucket. We're not supposed to be hungry. But in your flesh, you're going to be hungry. In the spirit, you can eat all day. Y'all ain't listening to me. Mom, I'm struggling. Because you an adult. He said in order to take on the kingdom, you must become as one of these. Come on, man. It's simple. Look, y'all can keep playing with this thing if you want to. We need to study together. He keep giving y'all examples after examples of how the spirit works. Here it is. He told me to do a panel study on Sunday. I'm not going to tell y'all what to study. Okay? But y'all going to teach on the same thing. You're going to finish what he's going to start. But when it comes to the flesh, you have to tell them what to teach. Y'all ain't listening to me. See, the flesh don't operate the way the spirit do. The spirit, it's always confirming itself. And he's giving you example after example after example. It's called evidence. That is to restore to the divine favor. The big word they like to use in church is atonement. The atonement, and y'all sitting there trying to figure out what they talking about. Man, talk plenty. Being born again is taking us back to our original intent and restoring our natural use. Because once we become spirit, we gain control back over the flesh so that the flesh goes back to its original intent, which is to be nothing but a vehicle. And we got earthly examples of that, right? We buy a car. Our mind says we need a car to get around, right? So our original intent for that car was to be used as a vehicle to get around, right? But then we buy the car. We look at the car. The car becomes pretty. Now that car becomes the ruler over us. Because we got to watch it every second to make sure don't nobody touch it, scratch it, put a dent in it. You can't do nothing without that car. You got that. You understand what I'm saying? But its original intent was to do nothing but for you to get it and to get where you're going.
I got one more.
Can't skip steps. When you look at what you deal with daily, there are small tests that raise us spiritually. Every day, there's a test that is supposed to raise you spiritually. Every day. Not every other day. Every day. The way we use to do things is the battle we are fighting, because it always tries to exalt itself over our newness. So whatever the test is, it's a battle of your old self trying to creep back in to make you do the things that you used to do and react the way you used to react when you was in your flesh. In order to completely die to those ways, you have to go through the training. You got to go through it. You can't avoid it. You can't skip it. You can't step over it. You can't run from it. You got to go through it. If a baby never learns to crawl, majority of the time it will never learn to walk. Simple. Because there's steps to it. Most babies who don't start off crawling and learn to walk first don't have the proper strength in their legs, so they become bow-legged. I didn't even know that, bitch. There's always evidence of when you skip steps. There's evidence of you skipping steps. If you leave and go get your body work done, it don't match your body. There's evidence. If you go and get the liposuction, the body, when you get your body smaller without going through the proper work of exercises, they normally got a big head with a small body. There's evidence. And y'all know I'm not lying. There's always evidence of skipping steps. Let's do it spiritually. Okay? You born again, you a believer. Somebody of another faith want to come to you and challenge you on your on what you believe in, you get upset. Why? Because you skip steps. You don't know the word the way you're supposed to, so now you're angry. That's evidence of you skipping steps. Y'all ain't listening to what I'm telling you. Just shut up. I don't want to talk to you. You ain't said a word to me. Training on the job. If you miss some training, there will be some things you don't know how to do and leave you guessing. If you go on the job and they skip steps in your training, there will be things that you do not know how to do on that job. Soon you will feel lost, not understanding where you are and how you got there. 99% of the reason why we start hating our jobs is because we weren't properly trained in it. Then you try to figure out how you even got where you are.
I don't even know how.
Something was skipped. Somebody wasn't properly trained. You can't skip steps. Listen, y'all, this is pretty simple. This is pretty simple. In order for you to be trained, you should be in the house where the training is taking place.
Yes.
We still using COVID-19 as an excuse to why we ain't assembling together. Do you not understand that just being assembled together allows the spirit to touch the room? Your spirit can't be spoken to over the computer. Where two or three are gathered in my name. Gathered!
I need a word on my life. Let me log in.
Skipping steps. You skipping steps. In order for you to be dedicated to something, there must be a changing of the mind. The reason why you can't come the way you want to come is because you're trying to skip steps. You have to force yourself into the spirit. Because the flesh is warring against the spirit.
Yes.
Fight back. We just lay down. We know the flesh strong because every time somebody say something to you, you ready. The bad part is the spirit is stronger. We just ain't training. We just don't fight for it the way we... We ain't going to be able to skip steps in this process, y'all. I'm trying to tell you. The reason why you're seeing evidence of small pockets of things is because he got on the check engine like to tell you something in your life need to be checked. You need to go back where I told you to be. And don't move till I tell you to move. Look, I don't know why it's me. I don't know why y'all got to sit under me. It is what it is. I know we ain't in no big building and ain't no music. I know ain't none of that. That ain't your process. You got to have your process. Huh? Because what I can promise you is all they getting is a good workout.
That's good.
Huh? They getting a good workout that they gonna put they gonna put the cars right back on at the service at the buffet.
It's a bodily exercise profit loop.
Yeah. Because the thing that changes you is direct word. Yeah. And because of our sensitivities of the flesh, people are not able to give us the word directly. Y'all ain't listening to what I'm telling you. I can give you an earthly example. Somebody breath stank, but instead of you being able to tell them they breath stank, you got to pull out some gum and eat some gum so that they can ask for some.
Right. You don't
want to
offend
no
back.
Huh?
You're right.
Why can't you say them, hey man, you skipped the step this morning? Huh? You skipped the step this morning, brother. It's okay. Hey man, it's all right. You got to ride out the car with your head and nose out the window because you ain't. But you're supposed to love them.
Right.
You're supposed to love them. But if we thought of ourselves as children would say anything.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Not only would they say it, they're going to say it wrong. Whoa, what's that smell? That's your breath smelling like that?
That's good.
Huh?
Children. Well.
Because children are innocent and raw. They don't really mean nothing by it.
Right, they don't.
They just trying to tell you what's going on. Hey, amen. See, children don't have the worries of the world. They don't pay bills. Right. Y'all listen to what I'm telling you. I'm breaking this thing down. They don't pay bills. Huh? They ain't worried about going to work. They ain't worried about how they gonna put clothes on. That's your job. They ain't worried about what they're going to eat or how they're going to eat. That's your job. See, when we become children, our father is able to take care of us, and we don't have them worries.
Y'all ain't listening to me.
That's good.
They got one job. Get up and go to school to learn. Y'all ain't listening to me. See, they in training. Mm-hmm. So we took the first step. We became new. But ever since we became new, we put back on old. We have not yet walked in the newness of life. And we wonder why our pockets, when we pull them out, we only pull out lint. You ain't got no authority. If a grown person come to me and ask me for $5, I'm probably going to look at them like, why you ain't got $5? But if a child comes to me and asks me for $5, man, I'm a brick. Let me see if I got it. I might got 10. Let me see. Do you understand what I'm saying? There's a difference. See, that adult that came to ask for $5, that's the flesh coming up with somebody. But when you come with the spirit, I'm giving you an example. Last night, me and my wife went to get something to eat. And she wanted some water, so I went over to get her some refills of water. And I was standing, there was a woman sitting behind me. And she said, I never had put my stuff on last night. I put on everything I had. I put on everything I had. You know what I'm saying? So I'm standing there, and the lady, I'm getting the water, and the lady said, I ain't gonna say the name. Said, you such and such down, ain't it? Like, let's just say you had on Carhartt. That ain't what I had on. But let's say you had on Carhartt. Oh, you Carhartt down, ain't it? And while she was saying that, the Holy Spirit just talking to me, right? So I don't know how to really respond to this lady, because the Holy Spirit dealing with me, and this lady is saying something. So he's saying what she really saying is, how can I get there? But she don't know how to say it. What she really saying is, I see something in you. How do I get there? And she don't know how to say it. So we respond in the flesh. We try to make somebody feel bad about looking at you. Because they don't know how to, y'all. How come you couldn't just say, hey? Or what you got on looks nice. Or what you got on look bad if you don't like it. Whatever the case, or just shut up. This is how the flesh reacts. This is what we do every day, though.
Wait, so that wasn't a compliment? What she said?
It was a compliment to me. But she didn't mean it as one. Let me tell you something. I'll tell you something about a compliment. You know one when you get it.
Yeah, she said you got that stuff.
Yeah, but that ain't how she said it. You understand what I'm saying now? Especially niggas. Because I know how we talk. Yes, sir. You don't speak nigga? You speak nigga, don't you?
I wouldn't be like you when I grow up, but you are, y'all both grow
up. You know good and well you ain't meaning that good.
I wouldn't be like you.
And the whole time you saying it, you looking them up and down. Well, nothing good about that statement. She might as well have said, you're doing too much. You got me? Yeah. See, we do that, man. We try to act like we don't know what's going on. Man, you know. Why are you pretending you don't know? You know. All right, I'm going to stop there. I'm going to keep going. I hope I said something that was edifying y'all today. I hope we brought out a message today that y'all was able to hold on to. Father God, we want to thank you for another opportunity to be in your presence. Father, we are even thankful for your latter rain. The peace that has brought us on today, Father, we are thankful for. We know that everything needs watering, Father. Your grass, your trees, your plants. And Father, we are thankful for the watering of our spirit on today. Father, we want to thank you for all the things that you do, Father. I ask right now, if there's anybody in the midst, Father, that needs prayer, Father, that you touch their hearts on today, Father. Father, I hope that this word, Father, pierces the flesh today, Father, and enters into the hearts of man. Father, we want to be your children, Father. We want to be trained by you. We want to be raised by you. To deny our flesh, Father, and give our bodies a living sacrifice, which you said is our reasonable service. So, Father, we are thankful for all these things. In your Son, Yeshua's name we pray. Hallelujah. Alright, thank everybody for coming in. At this time, we are going to take up an offering for anybody, not yet, baby, for anybody that wants to give. The Cash App is this is the wave at Cash App. $, this is the wave. Again, that's $, this is the wave. Anybody need an envelope or anything? Or everybody good? But we are thankful for everybody that stopped in. We do this every Friday at 7:45. Every Sunday at 11:30. Prayer begins at 11. Next week, we will be taking a week off. I don't know. I may go live at some point next week. I think I might. But other than that, and I'll send a notification out for anybody that wants to hear that. But we are thankful for everybody for stopping in. And we're going to see y'all. I don't know what that date is, but we'll see y'all guys again in about a week. And we thank for everybody for stopping in. We'll see y'all next time, sure.